So hello everyone, this is Jean-François Philippot. I'm very glad to welcome you on board this DIME webinar. So DIME is a project that deals with the modeling and the observation of extreme sea states for the offshore renewable energy, and with a focus on breaking waves that induce specific loads that we will be discussing later. So on this slide, you have the partners of the project, many industrial partners, many academic partners, and this is a project that is led by France Énergie Marine. On the bottom right, you have the ANR that funded the project with the investment for the future program, and also the filière mère of the Crédit Agricole. We funded a part of the project, especially the experiment conducted from La Jument Lighthouse that I will be discussing later. And other fundings come directly from the partner of the project. So here you have the different people that will be talking today. Myself, so I'm Jean-François Philippot. I'm the scientific director of France Énergie Marine, and I'm also the leader of the DIME project. Then we have Fabien Leclerc, who is an expert working for France Énergie Marine, and with expert on modeling and observing waves offshore and nearshore. Mathias Delpe, who is a research and development manager at Suez, and also an expert in wave and hydrodynamic modeling in the coastal and nearshore areas. And Christophe Maisondieu, who is a researcher on the offshore renewable energies and on the behavioral structure at sea at Ifremer. Okay. So here you have an overview of the agenda. So I will give a very short introduction of the project and of the objectives of the project. Then we will have four very exciting talks from Fabien Leclerc on wave modeling in extreme conditions. Then we'll have a talk of Mathias Delpe about characterizing areas of high waves at potential ovary sites. Then I will give a talk about the breaking waves loads on offshore wind turbines, presenting a party work done by Marc Prévosto from Ifremer, who could not be here today. And then Christophe Maisondieu will give you an overview of the recommendations that will be one of the main output of the project for the industrial sector. And then we'll have an interactive Q&A session. So you will be able to ask questions through the chat on the screen that you can see on your screen. So you will be able to ask questions all along the presentations, and then we will go through most of the questions or all the questions if we can all along this Q&A session. Okay. Okay. So just a few words about the objective of the project. The main objective is to reduce the uncertainties in the design of array converters regarding slamming loads. So slamming loads are specific loads that affect array converters exposed to breaking waves. I guess if you ever swim on a beach exposed to breaking waves, you already experience this load. It's a load that you feel when a wave, breaking wave, is slamming on your chest or your back. When you are walking across the waves. And what is very specific, it can be a very intense load, very short in time. It can excite modes of array converters such as offshore wind turbines. It can cause local damages, vertical excursions that we call run-ups that can damage access platform on offshore wind turbines, for instance, or green water that are submersions of the platform by breaking wave waters. So these are the main dangers that are related to slamming loads and breaking waves. So here you have a list of improvements that were expected from the project, but I'd rather share the second. Oh, sorry. Okay, I have an issue with my slides. Let me do it again. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, now I'm back. Okay, so here you have a sort of summary of the main results of the project for the design of offshore renewable energy converters. So I should have mentioned that here we are talking mostly about offshore wind turbines, but this kind of result can also affect any floating device that is designed to harvest ocean energy. It could be also applicable to wave energy converters, for instance. So I try to express the result along the different steps that you need to follow to design an ORI converter. So the first steps consist in defining a climatology for the storm system. The second one is to pick the sea state that is the most dangerous within this climatology. And in this sea state, we will capture the most dangerous waves that will be used to evaluate the slamming loads on the ORI converters. So for the first step, which is the sea state climatology, we perform different results. One of them is a proposition for a specific value for the gamma parameter for the Jones-Watt spectrum. So the spectrum is distribution of the energy along frequency. It's a very important information for the design. And the gamma parameter gives you the width of the spectra, which is, I can try to show with my mouse, and that will give you basically the irregular property of the wave feed. Then we have been working on the development of a specific version of the WaveWatch 3 model dedicated to storm modeling. So it is still ongoing, and we will be finishing this within the coming weeks. And we also developed a methodology that enables us to use satellite images to validate models and to qualify the horizontal or the spatial variations of the wave field in coastal areas and to identify an area of high or breaking waves that should be avoided, for instance, for the deployment of an offshore wind turbine because it's dangerous. Okay, so once you have your sea state climatology, you want to know which sea state is the design sea state for the slamming load. And one of the most important information is to know whether you have breaking waves or not, of course, in your sea state. So for this, we have developed a new formulation that gives the probability of breaking of large breaking waves in any sea state. So for the next step, which is the definition of the design waves in the sea states we selected, we developed different approaches. The first one is a new breaking criteria that we published in a paper recently, and that enables us to capture more precisely the instant of breaking and therefore the properties of the breaking waves at breaking, meaning especially the geometry of the breaking waves and the fluid velocity in the crest that you need to compute the slamming loads. We also perform improvements of deterministic wave models that are able to reproduce the wave evolution and transformations toward breaking to give important information or to be used for the evaluation of slamming loads. And we constructed a database of giant breaking waves from which we expect to we think we can extract relevant information regarding the properties of breaking waves at sea, which are a big unknown at sea. And for the last step, which is the evaluation of the slamming loads, we issued recommendations for the industry on which approach to follow. So Christophe and I will be presenting that during this webinar. And we also developed a protocol to measure the different parameters of interest, especially the shape of the breaking waves, the crest velocity, then the pressure on the structure and the structural response of the structure. And we did that on a lighthouse, and this protocol is being exported on the former high wind demo in Norway. We are waiting for a weather window to deploy the sensors.